this video, I'll be eating a half rack of ribs, collards, sweet potatoes, and maybe if I still have room, some cornbread. I also have some sweet tea, but it's unsweetened. I'll talk about that in a moment. So before I talk and ramble too much and everything gets cold, let me get everything out. I'm going to put it onto a plate. It's all separated into individual containers. First up, I have the collards, collard greens. There's a lot of water or collard green juice. I don't know what you want to call it, but looks like there is a chunk of ham or pork. You can listen to some of those. This is the sweet potatoes. Now these look really good. Hopefully you can see that. There's a lot of, looks like sweet potato, what do you want to call that? Like almost like a syrup type consistency. Look at that, nice. Looks like fresh yams. See that, chunks? Not just mush. There's actually, like, you can somewhat see it, almost like a syrup consistency. This is from a local place. They're only open a few days a week. I also have some cornbread. I'm gonna take this out because I don't know about you, but I hate the sound of styrofoam. I don't really have, I think it's called a misophonia, when certain sounds, like, you know, nails on a chalkboard, things like that. Well, for me, it's sometimes touching, like, dry paper towels, or the sound of styrofoam. So I'm going to take the cornbread out. And this looks... I'll put that on the back of ribs. So I'm also going to take this out of the styrofoam. It's not bad, nice, you know, it's like drinking cold tea. If you like regular tea, hot tea, right? Well, it's like drinking that, but cold. I like it. So I decided to opt for the unsweetened because I'm having sweet potatoes. I don't want to have too much sugar. All right. But when you're young, when we get older, we have to be careful. All right. That's enough talk. It's been 10 minutes, 15 minutes. Let's see if I can... Bon appetit. Very tender. I'm not sure if you have access to anything like this where you live. I'm not going to eat the whole rack of ribs or the whole half rack. A little too much. Let's try some of the collards. Save the sweet potatoes for last. This is the kind of meal that I love. So have some of the some of this cornbread. Just break off a piece. Well, you can't really break off a piece. This is the type of meal that I really prefer. I like steak, ribs, ham, just plain with its natural, you know, fat and the juices that come with it. I don't like to cover the meat that much in A1 sauce or anything. Now, I do like, you know, the barbecue, but I've slow cooked ribs myself and didn't, you know, douse them in barbecue sauce. I really like eating as close to natural as possible. Access to this type of food where you live, and how do you like your meals, your food? Do you like everything covered in, you know, ketchup or gravy? Does it have to have some kind of sauce on it, or do you like things prepared in a very simple manner like this? this stuff. I don't know what it is about collard greens and spinach. There's something just tastes so good about something that just has a very bitter, bland taste to it. There's nothing very flavorful about them, but I can just, you know, heat up some spinach, cook it, saute it, and it's just one of the most delicious things. Of course, I'm a foodie, so I like almost everything, but again, just a friendly reminder, I'm not like some highly cultured person that's traveled the world and has had everything. I haven't. I've had everything here in the United States, but a wide range of things, you know, sushi, Chinese food, which isn't really what Chinese people eat. So, Italian food, of course. Want some more of that collard greens. ASMR, collard greens, collard greens, collard greens. Okay. All right. Get that cornbread onto a fork. It's not really iced tea, just cold, unsweetened black tea, but that's good. Okay, time for some of this sweet potato. Let's have out some sweet potato ASMR. So just make some of those gooey type of sounds. That's delicious. Cinnamon, brown sugar. As much as it would be a very hard and difficult life living in that, what I believe, living that utopian lifestyle, which I believe was that hunter-gatherer, like the Native American Indians or any Aboriginal tribe, to me, that was the utopian type of society. So to speak, community. But I don't want to get into all that. As much as that life would have been difficult, I always think about how great it would have been to go hunt, get your own food. You get all that aggression exercised in a healthy manner by hunting. You have that goal every day, multiple times a day, and then you come back and then you cook it over a fire. And then you rest, some moment of peace, take care of your whatever the other responsibilities that you are. But that would have been great, just to hunt, get your own food, and then cook and prepare it. because I am going to finish all this. I don't really eat breakfast. It depends on the mood I'm in. let's finish up the sweet potato. Look at that. And now you might not be able to tell, but I can see all the flecks of cinnamon all scattered throughout. And it has a very syrupy type of, you can see that just dripping right there, type of consistency or texture from the brown sugar being added to it. Well, that's good. I'm glad I got a unsweetened drink. This is another wonderful thing about our species, dessert. As much as living that utopian lifestyle that I think about very often, hunter-gatherer, being very in tune with being human, it would mean giving up cake, sweet potatoes, probably, you know, unless you have access to sugar, no chocolate, you know, but if you were raised in that lifestyle, you wouldn't know any better. And maybe the sweet you get would be from berries and things like that. See that? It's just nothing but sweet potato goo right there. This is like the best part. This is like when the ice cream melts and it's just the soup. Or after you eat the chocolatey cereal and you're left with chocolate milk. something about the sound at the bottom.